Good evening, everyone. Tonight we got our first taste of team-on-team action here on WWAY Sports. The defending state champs, Wallace Rose Hill, opened up their house in Teachy and welcomed in South Columbus, East Bladen, Ashley, and East Duplin. So let's start off with the hosts. Our friend of the program, Kevin Motzinger, has his dogs ready. And we know they like to run a little misdirection for the nice gain up the left side of the field on their opening drive. That will set him up in the red zone. This time, give it to the big fake fullback. Running to the outside, little fake move, gets to the end zone for the score. No rust early for the Bulldogs. Inside the 20 now, because, of course, Coach Mott and company has him there. Back to the misdirection. Check out this stiff arm, folks. Watch this. Oh, take a seat. Back into the end zones, right towards our camera. Wallace showing why they don't rebuild, they reload. It'll be a tough out for New Hanover on Friday night at the Jamboree. How about a pair of East teams? Battle Holly and Robbie Priest talking it over on the field in this one. East Duplin took full advantage of their offensive drives. What a run here. Look at the breaking tackles. Get off me. Spin move to the end zone. High stepping it in for the score. Now, after some passing, set him up in the red zone again to the ground for 6. Big man piling it over the line for the second touchdown in the 10-play series. East Bladen's turn to capitalize. You know they could ground a pound. This time, send the back out on motion, swinging on out to him, and just get into some open space. Check out the collision. Boom, right there to get over the end zone. Touchdown, Eagles. Offense showed sparks with a new quarterback and running back in that backfield. Now for a pair of area teams, Ashley and South Columbus, in a BB&T rematch from a year ago. Screaming Eagles are on defense early. And they get the sack here. That play got to be blown dead to keep the quarterback safe, but they would respond. South Columbus with a run right towards our cameras. Coming to your living room here, folks. Touchdown, South Columbus, one of their 10-play stretch. Coach Turner trying to get that offense going, but this isn't a way to do it. Stuffed in the backfield, gang tackle, get to the ball. Fired up the coaches there for the Stallions. So the Ashley Eagles will try the air. Nice bootleg action. Get it out for a nice little pickup. Each team showed some nice things on either side of the ball this evening.
Quarter previews brought to you by Carolina Sports Medicine.
We continue our five-county tour with Brunswick County. It will be a new look this season with two of the three teams bringing in new head coaches. But all three have the same task of getting past the big dogs in conference to put Brunswick County on top. In Boiling Spring Lakes, Rocky Lewis is the elder statesman of the group with 2 years as the head man of the South Brunswick Cougars. He returns to a team who won only 3 games a year ago, but competed through the losses, and with the bounce of the ball the other way, more wins could have came. Returning their starting quarterback is a major plus, and Coach Lewis hopes to lean on that experience to start the year fast and finish strong.
We feel like we've got to be successful non-conference-wise and then build on that for the conference. And being able to compete against those bigger schools is a good challenge. We are the smallest school in the conference, student population-wise. And so that is a challenge, but our guys don't shy away from it. We embrace it, and our goal is to get better each year, and I think we've done that.
In Leland, North Brunswick hopes to get better this year after finishing in last place in the Mideastern Conference. While they face the challenges of replacing several key pieces, they also have the challenge of introducing their third coach in as many years. Larry Brock went to South, Darren Willis is out, enter Brian Davis. He hopes his experience as a coach in this conference and setting a standard of continuity will help turn the North program around.
If I can kind of, you know, domino it all the way down and let them value me as a person and let them know I'm not going anywhere, and when I yell at you, I love you. But I'm very much on that idea. You're going to do it this way because I want you to feel success. I want you to feel pride. I want you to feel like you can walk down the hallways and really feel that you've done something promised.
Brett Hickman felt that way walking down the hallways of West Brunswick. Now he's the coach of the Trojans. West found themselves in the playoffs once again, but out in the first round. They look to replace 17 seniors, including their starting quarterback, defensive playmaker, and bruising running back, to name a few. Hickman looks to take his experience coaching in college football to Friday nights and help West improve to dominance.
The biggest thing that we have to improve upon is us. If we take care of West Brunswick today, shouldn't matter if you're playing South, shouldn't matter if you're playing North, shouldn't matter if you're playing New Hanover and Hoggard. worry about yourself and then game plan accordingly to whoever you're playing that week. But we just need to see improvement every day with what we do.
We will see if that improvement comes with each of the Brunswick teams Friday night in the BB&T Jamboree. Our final night of previews before our big show comes tomorrow night when we check in with New Hanover County. Then you could go to sleep knowing Friday football is back. It's like Christmas week, Amanda.